What is poppin', fam? My name is Brennan Myers, and in today's video, we're gonna be talking about acne and how you get rid of it. Bye bye, acne. We'll talk soon. Let's ride. Okay, acne. A lot of people have been asking me to make a video on this for quite some time, and I'm talking about like 7 years or 6 years since I started YouTube. So here we go. Yes, right now I have a Gatorade and I'm using it for a prop to explain. I don't know where this went, but I'm gonna use it for a prop to explain kind of the whole gist of acne in general. So first of all, if you're going to a dermatologist, consult with your doctor. I am not a doctor. I'm coming from real life experience and I'm gonna give you some pieces of advice. I'm also just going to give you some tips and things that you can use maybe in the shower or maybe after, before your workout. First thing first that you need to know, if you're young, the fact of the matter is a lot of people get acne. Did you have acne, Taylor?
Oh yeah.
Everyone pretty much gets acne. And it's a shifting of your hormones. And so if you have a lot of testosterone, it's spiking like crazy, or you have testosterone that's high and it's estrogen that's also pretty high, and it's gonna be a little loud because of this truck, then you can expect acne pretty much in your teenage years. Now, I dealt with a lot of acne, as you can see with my scarring. You can really, really see, right? A lot of scarring on my face. I might have scarring even on my back. Not too much, just slightly. And I deal with acne on a consistent basis, and my pores maybe are a little bit more open than others, and I get more dirt. I couldn't tell you specifically why I get acne, other than a couple of things I'm gonna talk about in this video. So first off, go check out your doctor. So how did I get rid of my acne? It's a trick question. I didn't get rid of my acne. My acne just got rid of itself. And what I mean by that is I aged. I got older. And as I got older, you know, I started to see things. You can do specific things, and I'm gonna get into some treatments, quote unquote treatments. I don't wanna call them treatments. But things that you could be doing every single day, lifestyle changes that can assist in reducing acne. But generally, it comes down to your transformation and development, you know, puberty. When you're starting to get hair under your armpits or whoever it is, even if you're a female watching this right now, as you age, things are gonna happen. So it got rid of itself, and eventually I didn't have anything left on my face. Now I'm gonna tell you this right now. Do not, absolutely do not pick. Do not. I learned the hard way. If you have a white head, let it go. I know it might suck for a week. It might suck because you're walking into school and everyone's staring at you. Look, I've been there, but do not pick or else you're going to have long-lasting scars. And my scarring has gotten a lot better over the years. You don't wanna go through microdermabrasion. You don't wanna go through all the processes, all these chemical peels and all this shit. Also, don't take Accutane. I'm just gonna say that straight up. I don't care if a doctor's watching this and like, oh no, whatever. Do not take Accutane. I'm just gonna say it. Because there's a lot of effects that come from it. There's a lot of side effects, a lot of things you have to worry about. I mean, you have to go and get your blood done every month or every 2 months. That's what I've heard. My parents said, absolutely not, we're not going on Accutane. And thank God I never did, because that can cause a lot more issues than just having acne. Yeah, it might take it away, but you might form some other issues. And I don't wanna get into anything else because there's so many different things that can come from it. So that's another thing. Okay, so really, what are other, like, things that you can be doing every single day to get rid of this acne? Number one, if you're working out a lot, you know, sweat goes into the pores, like a little bacteria forms, it forms a bump, whatever it is. I highly, highly, highly suggest immediately after the gym, you take a shower. Now, you don't wanna use too much soap. You don't wanna use all of these different products. That can actually affect your skin in a way that you don't want it either. Dry skin, it can make it even more oily. There's a lot of things that you don't want to do. You can form a lot of issues from too much moisturization or moisturizing. You can do it from too much water and rubbing and things like that. A lot of this stuff can come from it. So my suggestion, and this is what I do, I shower twice a day. Now one shower is with a little bit less soap. And I don't use something that's so aggressive. Something very, very mild. I use like eucalyptus, this salt. This salt bar, this bar of salt, I can't speak, salt soap. salt soap, Dead Sea salt soap, something like that. And I use that at night, so that's a little bit more scrubbing. And I also, for my first shower after my gym, I don't use any like washcloth or anything that really, really is scrubbing hard. It's just a quick wash on my body and then I'm in and out. I do it immediately after the gym. I don't eat first. I don't like go in and get into a meeting. Sometimes I have to and I, oh my gosh, I have acne the next day, surprisingly. So get your shower in as quickly as possible. Also, shower before you go to bed, 100%. A lot of the times I hear people that, you know, they have a long day, but they only shower in the mornings. Hello, the whole point of your bed being clean is that you're sleeping in a clean bed, so it doesn't affect your skin and a lot of other factors. So I highly suggest you take a shower at night, and that's when you wanna use a daily, like a scrubber or something like that. That's another thing. Use something like a cloth or something, but wash it consistently. You don't wanna just use it for a month, 2 months, and then wonder why you have acne. I mean, you gotta think about it. Every single time, even though you're in the shower, you can try and wash it off, whatever. It's not the same as washing in a washing machine. It's a whole different story, okay? So make sure you are washing your washcloths all the time. Another thing is nutrition. A lot of times, what we're putting in our body really, really affects it, actually the majority of time. So if you are a teenager, to aid in the success of removing this acne, it's look at your nutrition. So things like eating more vegetables, higher micronutrients, this all affects your hormones. And if your hormones are much more balanced, you're not gonna see a lot of reactions. Because a lot of acne, what it is just a reaction to something. So you might have a food insensitivity. So if you have a food insensitivity, that's a whole nother story. So there's one story of eating healthy, and there's another story of just a food insensitivity or sensitivity. So let's talk about, for me, if I eat a lot of eggs, I get acne on my back. It's common, I've seen it time and time again. You might wanna remove dairy and eggs out of your diet. And once you heal your gut, once you're not farting all the time or any of these issues, then it might be best to incorporate eggs or whatever else that you were consuming in your diet. So that's one of those ways as well. Nutrition is a very, very tricky thing. It can also be how many carbs, how many fats, and how many proteins are you consuming? Are you eating so many fats that like you're not eating enough carbs, that like your hormones are just shifting around all the time, or your macros all over the place every single day? Again, this all has an effect on your skin as well. A lot of the reactions, the things that we feel, are just a mirror to how we're eating and how we're treating our body. Another thing, sleep. Are you sleeping? Are you sleeping 5 hours? Are you sleeping 6 hours? Cortisol, increased cortisol has a huge effect on your acne and any types of bumps, your skin, everything like that. Also, environment. Where are you? Are you taking care of your skin? Are you moisturizing it? You do want it to be moisturized. And if you are in, let's say, Florida, and you're sweating all the time, all day, what do you think it's gonna do to your body? You know, you might wanna shift around clothes or try and be a little bit more in air conditioning quite some time. But generally, if you're doing a lot of exercise, you wanna make sure you're taking care of your body right after, and that's gonna be a shower and things like that. So there's so many different parts that you could really be focusing on to shift away and get rid of all this acne. Now, do you just get some sometimes if you're transforming? Of course, it's like puberty. It's like a mini cycle of puberty. For instance, me, I'm going through prep, and my show is in 54 days. I've been prepping for 13 weeks. During this time, I've lost more and more body fat, which is going to affect my hormones. And because of how quickly I'm actually losing it, some days I'll feel better than others. Other days, I'll be a little bit more stressed, and then also my business, and then also this and that. It all plays into it. So do I have a pimple right here? Yeah, maybe I was, I don't know, working out, and I went like this after grabbing a weight. Or maybe right here, this was an acne that I had. Like, I don't stress out so much about it because I know acne comes and it goes. And that's what you have to trust, is that it comes and then it goes. Do not focus so heavily, listen closely to this, do not focus so heavily on that one thing that is on your body. It will leave, it will go. It's a whole different story if you got like something serious. I'd rather have acne all day than something serious that doesn't go away that you have to have treatments for. You don't need treatments for acne. Many times, you just need to let it run its course. And if it's not running its course, then there's something off outside of puberty, or you just transform it. There's something off, and you should go look at your hormones, you should get your blood tested, you should change your nutrition, your diet, add in some cardio, maybe you're just stressed, you need to, something's toxic in your life, you're so busy, your environment, it could even be your sheets. Wash your sheets, even every week if you can. Clean sheets. Would you rather be sleeping on something that's clean or something that has a little bit more bacteria on it and it's a little nasty? Trust me on this. I've been through the process. So that is the video for today. Hopefully you got something out of it, how to get rid of acne. It's not so much about how to get rid of it, it's how to work with it and strategize to keep it off of your skin. Moisturize, take care of yourself, nutrition's huge, working out is huge. Trust the process and you'll be good to go. Hey, don't forget, Create Your Nutrition. We are out and we are rolling. The Greens Juice link is in the description. If it's sold out, I'm very, very sorry. It's selling like wildfire. We also have Creatine HCL. It might be, no, it's not released yet. Link will be in the description just for the hell of it, for whenever you're ready. Probably the end of this week, we'll have it out. And if you're watching this and it's past the end of this week, it's there. Pick yours up now. I take Creatine HCL and not monohydrate for several reasons. One, I just enjoy it, it's quicker. And then also the podcast every Tuesday and Friday. Don't miss out. Every Tuesday, I generally have a guest. Every Friday, we jump into some crazy shit and we have fun with it. We grab a topic. If you want to send a review, that would be really, really appreciative. If you want to send any questions, send me a DM on Instagram at the B Myers. I'm out here trying my best, working as hard as possible to bring you to the next level. Create you. Thanks for tuning in for another video, and I'll see you next time. Peace.